I swear, guys, this teacher is the chillest dude. He puts up with so much with these children. It's unbelievable. Like, if I was me, I would have, like, bashed one of them over the head by then, just playing. But, man, it's insane. He's such a pacifist, and I relate to that. I'm a pacifist too. Yeah. So anyway, let's dig right into this.
The S is silent.
You're fucking gay. Marcus!
Chill! Damn! Just chill! This video just started! He's so original! Ho ho ho! When he gets older, I don't want to drink around him. He'll be like, "Oh man, oh, I seen those F slurs over there kissing and stuff, man. It disgusts me. My masculinity hurts." Fuck, dude.
No, you shut up, you dyke bitch.
For some reason, the caption said a diet
bitch. Dyke bitch.
What's a regular bitch? He didn't say diet. He said something a lot worse. Oh, Mr. Edgelord. This Mr. Edgelord here either is in the closet himself or just has really homophobic parents. One of the two. Maybe both. Fucking hell.
Marcus, guess what?
What?
You're free to leave.
Like right now?
Like right now.
Alright, yo. Yeah, I'll catch you later.
Yeah, why the fuck was that ever like a bad thing? Like, oh, you get to leave the classroom, like you don't give a shit about. Go ahead. Go ahead and leave. That's a some being suspended for you. Shh. And expelled. Detentions are actually bad, but you want to up the ante to suspension so you can take a break from school. Just kidding. If you're in school, please don't up the ante. I'm kidding, but it makes students want to up the ante. It's like, oh, would I rather go in early in school and deal with a shitty ass time just sitting there before school starts, or should I up the ante and get a few days off and no detention whatsoever? Made no sense to me.
What the fuck? Do you want me to go to the dean's
Yeah, I
office? Or
don't
you
care
want
where you're going.
Everyone pull out a sheet of paper.
Sheet of paper, not shitty paper.
Pull out a sheet of paper. I'd like to assess where your individual writing skills
What if we
are.
ain't got no paper?
Okay, here's the situation. You're dead. All right, write a brief but detailed essay about.
Hey, jackass, I asked you a fucking question!
About.
Yikes. And I thought my patience was bad. Holy shit, dude. Calm the fuck down.
What a friend or a parent might say about you during your funeral.
Oh, tell a bunch of teenagers that are possibly already like have mental issues because of high school, telling them to write about a paper about them being dead. That's morbid as hell, dude. Morbid.
Okay. You have 30 minutes.
Oh shit. I asked you a motherfucking question, didn't I?
Anything else?
Better back the fuck up before I fucking rock your shit.
That bag, it doesn't have any feelings. It's empty. I don't have any feelings you can hurt either.
Yo, this is when like a troll tries to say like a bunch of shitty things to me, and I'm like, I'm already dead inside. Oh, what you gonna do?
Okay, I understand you're angry. I used to be very angry too, okay? I get it. You have no reason to be angry with me because I'm one of the few people that's here trying to give you an opportunity.
An opportunity for what? To learn a bunch of useless shit in school that's not going to help you for the real world, and then when you graduate, be totally clueless on how the real world works. And the 7 hours of crappy shit every single day. Thanks a lot. Hey, can you punch me in the balls too while you're at it? I think it'll be less painful.
Now I'm going to ask you to just sit down and do your best, and I'll give you a piece of paper. How's that?
That dude's the asshole whisperer, like, he knows every fart that's been around that area. Literally, that area.
Thank you.
Why'd you throw Marcus out of class, but not Jerry?
Well, I had to make an example out of somebody.
It's because he's black. If they would have, if they would have filmed that, they would have misconstrued the teacher being racist. And then, he'd get fired. And then he had to go on the news and apologize when he did nothing wrong. See, like, I'm being exaggerated, of course, but... Oh, gosh. All this racism is making me on. Just kidding, no racism.
Anyway, Marcus verbally assaulted you. That's not allowed in my classroom. You know, what they say to me is immaterial. What's your name?
Meredith.
Nice to meet you, Meredith.
So you really don't care what the kids say to you?
Guess I've gotten used to it.
I wish I could be that strong.
It doesn't take strength, Meredith. You gotta understand that, unfortunately, most people lack self-awareness. You should really keep that in mind as you head into the trenches of second period. You'll meet them again at every age.
I wish I could whisper like this to assholes and be the asshole whisperer. Hey, guys. In conclusion, you just gotta be a pushover in life, because when you're a pushover, people listen to you, you know? Apparently this guy does it, and when I do it, I get walked all over, so I don't know. This is up to you to decide what the moral is. I'm not fucking Sesame Street here, okay? I'm not giving a lesson out here. It's like teaching kids how to quit smoking cigars or something. I don't know. Fuck. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. And if you leave a like on this exact video, then if you have cancer, you'll be cured of it. And if you leave a like, any disease you have, you'll be immune to anything. You could go run in toxic waste and not get any you'll be good. You'll be good to go. Have sex with as many prostitutes you want. Go in and fuck them away. Subscribe if you're new. And no joke, no scam. That'll happen to you. You'll get immunity. Go ahead and jump in toxic waste. Just kidding. Anyway, and I'll see you when you watch me again. Metaphor. You'll see me when you watch me again, metaphorically. Yeah, that's how it usually goes. Peace.
Dragon backpack, Spanish class, tardy always. Grinch slipping too many classes to get started. Getting called names every day. I'm an easy target. Relationships.